Okay, let's do one problem on calculating the standard enthalpy. And remember, standard enthalpy is delta H with a degree sign because this is done in standard conditions. So all we have to do is find the data from the index or the appendix, wherever, or Google. Okay, but anyhow, this is the reaction that's given to us, and it is 3-methane, 3CH4 plus 2H2O. Plus carbon dioxide to give 4 carbon monoxide and 8 molecules of water. So the first thing you would do for this one is find the standard enthalpies, and from the back of the data tables, the standard enthalpy for methane is 74.81. The main thing you have to be careful about when you do all these things is look at the states, okay, because CH4 can be gas, liquid. So you want to make sure you get the right states. For water, in a liquid state is 285.8. For carbon dioxide, it's minus 393.5. And then for carbon monoxide, is 110.5. And for hydrogen, is going to be 0 because it's an elemental state. Now, all of these values are going to be in kilojoules per mole. So I'm not going to write the units yet. Okay, I'll write them later on. Now, the whole thing over here is that you will go ahead and do the product minus reactant, okay, to find the delta H. To find this, the product over here, okay, then you have to take the number of moles, okay, that you have times whatever you have, okay, here. So the times would be, say, for carbon monoxide, okay, minus the reactants, which means now you have to add up for all the reactants, which it's going to be N times the CH4 plus 2, which is for water, and then H2O plus 1 times CO2. Let me go ahead and finish this off over here by writing 3. So that's that. Okay, so that's what you have to do. Now, the other easier way to do this, okay, is, and you can plug in the values right here and do this too. The easier way to do this is to do that right there in the equation, okay, as it's given to you, because then this will be multiplied by 3, this will be multiplied by 2, this is multiplied by 1, this is multiplied by 4, and of course, this is 0, okay? And so once you get all the numbers on this side of the equation, and you have all the numbers on the right-hand side of the equations, then all you have to do is subtract from products to reactants. Okay, so then everything else is accounted for. Then you don't have to do the N over here. You've done it right there in the equation. Okay, and so here, after doing all the math here, and I will not write each number, you can do the calculation yourself. The product minus reactant, the total number of products was 442.0, because this is 0 anyway, and so then 442.0 kilojoules minus the reactants, which the total was minus 1189.5 kilojoules. Remember, minus and the minus, okay, and so that keep your numbers correct and your signs correct, okay, over here. So once you do that, then your answer, and this is minus, so your answer will come out to be plus 747.5 kilojoules. Okay, so that's what it would be. So this is an easier way of doing it rather than trying to set it up like this.